Find the minimal sum using QM method or Quine-McCluskey method. Let's consider an example. We have the expression f of the variables a, b, c, d with the min terms as given in the table, right? So since we have a don't care at position 2, we also need to consider a 1 for the don't care. So we have the binary notations given. So we consider the don't care, which is 0, 0, 1, 0, and then 3, 4, 5, 7, 10, 12, 14, 15, right? So the function f has an output 1 for 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, and so on up to 14, right? So I have written the decimal numbers here, and then its corresponding min term and the 1, 0 notation. So for 2 is 0, 0, 1, 0. So the min term would be A bar, B bar, C, D bar. So if I have a 0, I have a bar included. If there is a 1, we just write the variable as it is. And we also write the index. So what is this index? We basically check the number of 1s present in the 1, 0 notation. So here, for the first 1, 0 notation, there is a single 1, so index is 1. For the next, there are two ones, so index is 2 and so on. So this is the first step in trying to find the minimal sum using QM method. So after we write this table, then what we do is we group the min terms or the combinations having the same index, right? So I write the combinations having the same index. So here I have these two having an index 1. So therefore, I have the number 2, which corresponds to 0, 0, 1, 0, having an index 1. So this is A, B, C, D, the variables. And then 4, having an index 1, which is 0, 1, 0, 0. So index is 1. Right? So therefore, I write them together. And then next I choose the combinations where I have an index 2. So I have an index 2 for 3, 5, 10 and 12. So I have 3, which is 0, 0, 1, 1, index is 2. And then I have 5, where the binary notation is 0, 1, 0, 1, index is 2 again. And then I have 10, which is 1, 0, 1, 0, index is 2, and then I have 12, which is 1, 1, 0, 0, index is again 2. So next I need to write the combinations having index 3. So I have these two combinations which have an index 3, which is 7 and 14. So I have 7, which is 0, 1, 1, 1, having an index 3, and 14, which is 1, 1, 1, 0, index 3. And finally, I'm left with 15, having an index 4. So this is the next step, which is done using QM method. So first we get this table, and then we group the combinations having the same index. Now we compare index 1 and index 2. So when we compare index 1 and index 2, we identify the combinations where there is a single bit variation. For example, so here I have the variables A, B, C, D. So I compare 2 having an index 1 with all of them. Now when I compare 2, which is 0, 0, 1, 0 with 3, 0, 0, 1, 1, I find that there is a variation in only a single bit here, which happens to be the 4th bit position, right? So therefore, I write this combination as 2, 3, wherein we have 0, 0, 1. So the first three bits of 2 comma 3 happen to be the same, and the fourth bit is complementary, so I represent it by a dash. Similarly, I compare 2 with 5, 10 and 12. So 5 is 0, 1, 0, 1, 10 is 1, 0, 1, 0 and 12 is 1, 1, 0, 0. So I check if there is only a single bit variation. So when I compare 2 with 5, I find that these two bits, bit 2 and 4, vary. So I cannot write it here. Then I compare 2 with 10. So again I find that the first bit alone varies. Okay, so therefore I can write 2 comma 10. So when I consider 2 and 10, I find that only the first bit varies. I have a 0 here, I have a 1 here. So I put a dash. And next I have 0, 1, 0. 0, 1, 0. So next I compare 2 with the next combination, which is 12. So I have bit varying in the first and the second position. So therefore I do not consider it. Right? So therefore we have compared 2 with all the other combinations having an index 2. So next I need to compare 4 with all these 4 combinations. So let me consider 4. So I have 4, which is 0, 1, 0, 0. With that I need to consider 3, 5, 10 and 12. So first is 3, which is 0, 0, 1, 1. So again I find that there is variation in 3 bit positions. What are the 3 bit positions? It varies in the second bit and the third bit and the fourth bit. So I cannot write it here. Next, consider 5, which is 0, 1, 0, 1. So the first bit remains the same, the second bit remains the same, the third bit also remains the same. Only the fourth bit varies. So therefore, I can write 4 comma 5. So the next combination would be 4 comma 5. So therefore, I get 0, 1, 0 and a dash. So the variation is in the fourth bit. So next we consider 10, which is 1, 0, 1, 0. So variation in the first bit, second bit, third bit. So 10 and 4 is not a combination. So then we have 4 and 12. So variation is in the first bit and the remaining 3 bits are the same. So 4 comma 12 is definitely a pair combination to be written here. 4 comma 12, where the variation is only in the first bit. So I put a dash here and then I have 1, 0, 0. So this is obtained when we consider index 1 and index 2. So I'm done with index 1 and 2. So next we repeat the same process where we consider all the combinations having index 2 with the combinations having index 3. So now we need to compare them. So let us consider the first one in index 2, which is 3, 0, 0, 1, 1. I need to compare this with 7 and 14. So 7 and 14. 0, 1, 1, 1. And then 14 is 1, 1, 1, 0. So when I compare 3 and 7, there is a variation in the second bit only. So 3 and 7 is a combination. So we write 3 comma 7, where I can write 0 dash for the second bit, 1, 1. And then compare 3 with 14. So the first bit varies, the second bit varies, and the fourth bit varies, so it is not a combination. So next we move on with 5, 7 and 14. So we have 5, which is 0, 1, 0, 1, with 7 and 14. So I have 7 is 0, 1, 1, 1, and 14 is 1, 1, 1, 0. So when I observe, the first, second and the fourth bit remains the same except the third bit. Right? So I can write 5 and 7. and the first is bit is 0, 1, and a dash for the third bit, a 1 there. And comparing 5 with 14, it varies in the first bit position and the third and fourth. So therefore 5 comma 14 is not a combination. Next we move on with 10 with 7 and 14. So we need to compare 10, which is 1, 0, 1, 0. So when I compare 10 with 7, it varies in the first, second and the fourth bit. It is not a combination here. But 10 and 14, it only varies in the second bit position. So I have 10 comma 14, the first bit remains the same 1, the second bit is varying, the third, fourth is 1, 0. So next we compare 12 with 7 and 14. So 12 is 1, 1, 0, 0. So again compare 12 with 7. So it varies in the first, third and fourth. So these two do not form a pair. But when I compare 12 and 14, I find that it varies only in the third bit. So I have 12 comma 14. So the first two bits remain the same, 1, 1. The variation is in the third bit. I put a dash. And the fourth bit is 0. So here we have compared index 2 and 3. I'm done with that. So next we need to compare the combinations having index 3 and 4. So for that we need to compare 7 with 15. So obviously 7 and 15, if I observe these two, the variation is only in the first. So I have 7 comma 15, variation is the first bit, I write 1, 1, 1. And then if I compare 7, the next one, which is 14 and 15, the variation is the fourth bit. So I have 14 comma 15, so I have 1, 1, 1 and a dash. So we are through by comparing the combinations of index 1 and 2, which is here, 2 and 3, which is here, and 3 and 4, which is here. So what have we done? We have, when we compare the 4-bit binary combination with the neighboring indexes, we have actually considered those combinations where there is only a single bit variation, right? So when I compare 2 and 3, there's a single bit variation. The variation is in the fourth bit. If I compare 2 and 10, the variation is in the first bit, and so on. Now let me assign alphabets to these pairs. So now let us consider the first combination 2 and 3. So let me call that as Q. So let this be Q. The next one be R. S. T. Then we have U, V, W, X, Y and Z. So we have considered these combinations and we have named them as Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y and Z. So when I consider Q here, Q happens to be A bar, B bar and C alone, because D bar is not considered, because D is not considered here, isn't it? So therefore, when I consider combinations 2 and 3, it is common only for the variables A, B and C. So therefore, Q can be represented as A bar, B bar, C. Similarly, R can be represented as B bar, C, D bar. S can be represented as A bar, B, C bar, and T by B, C bar, D bar. So similarly, I have U, which is A bar, C, D, and then this is A bar, B, D, W is A, C, D bar, and X is A, B, D bar. And then I have Y, which is B, C, D, and Z is A, B, C. So we have written the variables for these alphabets which we have considered. Now let us form a table and let us compare them with the min terms. So here I have written the variables which correspond to these alphabets Q, R, S, T up to Z, and the columns I have written the min terms only, leaving the don't care. So the don't care is not considered, and I have written their min terms here. So M3 is nothing but A bar, B bar, C, D and so on. So now what we do is we compare where I have these three variables common occurring in these min terms. For example, if I consider Q, Q is A bar, B bar, C. So where do I get A bar, B bar, C? In which min term is A bar, B bar, C present? I find that I have A bar, B bar, C present in N3 and is not present in any of them. So I put an X here. I put a cross, rather to say. I put a cross there. So next, let us consider B bar, C, D bar. So check where we have B bar, C, D bar. So B bar, C, D bar is present only in M10. Right? So I put a cross there. Next, A bar, B, C bar. A bar, B, C bar is present in M4. And A bar, B is also present in M5. Right? Okay. So I put a cross here. A bar, B, C bar. A bar, B, C bar. Next, B, C bar, D bar is present in M4, and B, C bar, D bar is also present in M12, right? Okay, and then let's talk about U. U is A bar, C, D. A bar, C, D is present here, and then A bar, C, D is also present here and is not present anywhere else. Next, A bar, B, D. So A bar, B and D is present here. A bar, B, D is present here for M5. And A bar, B, D is also present here for M7. So I put an X there. Next, A, C, D bar. A, C, D bar is present here. And A, C, D bar is also present here. So it's present for M10 and M14. Next, ABD bar. So I have ABD bar is present here. And ABD bar is also present here for 12 and 14. Next, BCD. So BCD is present here for M7. And BCD is also present for M15. And next we have ABC. So ABC is present for M14 and M15. So we finish this table, or we complete this table, by considering the midterms where these three variables are occurring in common. Right? Okay. So now what do? We now check which variable dominates the other. And we also check which is the variable which has only one cross or one mapping, we should say. So we find that there is only one mapping if we observe. Okay, so now let us observe which variable dominates the other. Now let us consider the variable Q. Now Q is assigned for M3, but whereas U is assigned for M3 as well as M7. Right. So therefore I can score out Q, because Q is not required here, because U essentially maps M3 and M7. So there is no need for us to have both Q and U. So therefore we can delete Q, row Q. So row Q can be deleted. Right? So similarly here we again try to observe which is the variable which dominates the other. So here, W dominates R. So W we have for M10 and M14. Right? But I observe that the variable R is only mapped to N10. So therefore we can eliminate the row R. So row R can be eliminated. So we have eliminated two rows, which is Q and R. Because Q, there is no need for us to have Q because M3 is present in row U also. And there is no need to have R because M10 is present in W also. So we have deleted those two rows. The next job is to identify the essential rows, which also give us the prime implicants. Now if we observe the first column, I find that the first column, that is M3, is mapped to U, right? So M3 is only mapped to U. So therefore, this becomes essential. So therefore, U becomes essential. So U is featured in the minimal sum because the only representation of M3 would be U. So therefore, we observe the columns and we check where there is only one mapping. So I find that in the first column there is only one mapping for U, whereas the second column there are two mappings here, and then again there is a single mapping because we have already crossed out the first two rows. So we observe that there is only one mapping for N10, which is W. So therefore U and W are essential rows which get featured in the minimal sum. So now we have eliminated row Q and R. So let me erase this. So we have eliminated row Q and row R. Right? So similarly, we also have eliminated row U and W. So U and W also can be eliminated. So now we have the remaining part of the table with these alphabets ST, V, X, Y, and now since we have deleted the first two rows and we also have deleted row U and row W, now since X is mapped, that is M7 is mapped to U, so we also eliminate column M7, right? And M14, which is mapped to W, also gets eliminated. Right? So now we have eliminated row Q, R, U, W, and we also have eliminated the two columns M7 and M14. So now let us write the simplified table. So now to have the next table here, we observe that we have eliminated Q and R, and we find that U and W also have been removed from the table because they are essential here. And among the columns, we have also deleted M7 and M14. And since we have removed U and W, we also eliminate M3 and M10. So therefore, writing the remaining columns, we have M4, M5, M12, M15. So let me repeat, we have removed U and W, right? So as we remove U and W, we also eliminate M3 and M10. Because U is mapped to M3 and W is mapped to M10. So we have M3 and M10 which have been removed, and again we delete M7 as X is in row U, and we also remove M14 as X is in row W, right? X meaning the mapping is in row W. So now we write the mappings here. So I have X, X present here, then I have X, X, then I have X here, and then X, and then XX here. Right? So now what we observe, now when we observe these rows and columns, we find that some of the rows are absolutely similar. Now I find that row Y and row Z are absolutely similar, they are identical, so one of them can be removed. So these two rows, Y and Z, are identical, so remove one of them. So let me remove Z. So I remove row Z. Next, let me consider the term, the row which has a single term and the row which has more than one term. So we find that there is a single term. So now let us consider the rows which have a single term and rows which have more than one term. Now I find that B is mapped to M5, but whereas S is mapped to M4 and M5. So S is mapped to M4, M5, whereas V is mapped to M5. So we find that S dominates V, right? So delete row V. Now let me consider row T. So row T, the mapping is M4 and M12, whereas X is mapped to M12 alone. So we find that T dominates X, so delete row X. Right? So we have deleted row V and we have also deleted row X. So now we have these three rows, that is row T, row S and row Y. So we find that we need to have row S because row S is mapped to M5 only. We need to have row T which is mapped to only M12 and we need to have Y which is mapped to M15. Right? So there is a single term for M5, M12 and M15 which are mapped to S, T and Y. So therefore S, T and Y are required. Right? So we have U, W, S, T and Y which are selected for the minimal sum. So the final minimal sum of this expression would be U plus W plus S plus T plus Y. But what is U? U is defined by here A bar C into D. So U is A bar C into D plus W is A C D bar plus what is S? S is A bar B C bar plus T is B C bar D bar and Y is B C D. So finally we get the minimal sum using QM method. So what we need to remember is, given an expression here, first we need to write this table, find the indexes. So first write the numbers, their corresponding min terms, 1-0 notation and then index. Rearrange the rows such that we write the indexes in order, all the rows having the same index, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And then compare index 1 and 2 and identify where there is a single bit variation and group them. Give alphabets and then look into the table and identify which are the rows which are absolutely essential, which go in to form the minimal sum. Right? So as we go on deleting the rows and columns, finally we get the minimal sum, which are defined by these alphabets. And these alphabets are given by the expressions given from this table and we finally get the expression here. Right? So this is how we can find the minimal sum using QM method. Right? So when we compare QM method with the KMAP to find the minimal sum, QM method is pretty lengthy and it takes more time for us to find the minimal sum here, because you have a number of steps involved. So make sure that you practice the same method by taking different examples. So I hope you found the video informative. Please do like, share and subscribe and press the bell icon to get notifications on further uploads, and thanks for watching.